Good morning, Jeffrey Paul, with a lesson on the power of review. I want to inspire you today with something that is real. I mean, it's as real as when we were little kids in elementary school, and we would do the spelling words. Do you remember that? I hope some of you can. And you'd get 5, 7, 10 words. I don't remember what it was right now. And you'd write them out, and in the classroom, as you kind of rehearsed them and recited them and quizzed on them, you remembered them. But you went home and you did one of two things. You either reviewed them by writing them over and over again so that they really embossed themselves in your mind, or you forgot them. And then test time came and you got one of those C, D's, or the ugly E on your spelling test. Well, what does that have to do with living life today where you're at? Everything. I just got done this morning really reviewing last year's month of all of April and March. Why? That's 2016. That's a year ago. Why would I do that? I was amazed at how many things that were insightful and exciting and things that were valuable and insights of studies or programs that I'd gone to that without reviewing it, I began to forget it. And it was yesterday that I had a phone conversation with one of the people who I trained at one of my boot camps, 3 days of intense training on doing what I do, which is designing hair pieces and trichology and treatments for people that are losing their hair. We bring in professionals to learn this. 3 intense days, models and hands-on training and manuals and books and videos and PowerPoints. I mean, we give it all to them. As I was sharing with her yesterday, almost a 45-minute phone call, she so much desired when she was there the 3 days to absolutely hit the ground and running. And guess what happened? 2 months later, you got it. She began to forget about it. She got busy with life, and she so much wanted it 2 months ago, but now she had fallen short. So I introduced her to the coaching program that I began this year, and coaching only a few, but I coach them on reminding them of the things they want, the things they need to do to accomplish what they want. That's what I'm sharing with you. If you're not journaling, if you're not taking the time to write down the things you're learning on a day-to-day basis, the things that you're feeling, the things that you're going through today, as you go through that and look at it in the evening and refresh your mind, and then even the next morning before you write more journaling, that review, the power of that review alone is so impactful for it to become a practice of your life, a discipline of your life. It really is. And then a year from now, you can look back and see what you've either forgotten, overlooked, not put into practice, or check off with great celebration what you've done. So again, the power of review for a teacher like a Janet, my cousin who's on here today, would tell you, I believe, that the power of review over and over and over again embosses it. It brings it into illumination, enlightenment. And the power of that is what you need to do on a regular basis. So here's your challenge for today. I want you to journal. If you don't journal, please take this motivation to empower your life. Journal. And I'll share more with you on journaling. Maybe we'll do something tomorrow in our longer version tomorrow about how powerful journaling is, but not a diary per se. A journal that, yes, tells your paper what you're feeling, your emotions, but I want you to pretend, and I'm going to say that word cautiously, I want you to imagine that you're sitting with the greatest coach of all time. And as you're writing, you're speaking to that coach, the greatest coach that can take you to the highest level of performance, could take you and direct you to your destiny. I want you to write out what you might be feeling, what you're going through, what the issues are in your life, just jotting the basics. Then I want you to put the pen down, and I want you to take a moment to hear that coach, that inner, still, quiet voice of the coach within you. And as you listen, I then want you to pick up the pen again. I want you to write down what you're hearing. Now, you may not hear a lot in the beginning. You might not even hear anything in the very beginning. But as you continue to practice this discipline of journaling, and you start to write down what you hear, for instance, I'm really worried about a circumstance in my life, la da 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 da. You put your pen down and you listen to the coach. And the coach says, I don't want you to worry about a thing. I take care of the birds of the air. I take care of the sunrise and sunset, and it never fails. I'll take care of you. Here's what I want you to do. Write it down. Then, that evening, I want you to review it. I want you to review it. The power of review. Maybe that's 12 hours later, but you will not. You'll be shocked how much you've forgotten, how much you have not remembered. And, you know, the Proverbs constantly says, remember these things. Put them into practice. Remember these things. Refresh these things within you. So in the evening, you go through that journal just before you go to bed. Let it sink in so that while you're sleeping through the night, it's processing, it's reviewing itself on autopilot. Are you following me? And then, what's wonderful is when you wake up in the morning, there's a refreshment of renewing your mind. Review it again. The power of review. Review it again so that it refreshes you to now begin to start journaling all over again. This could take maybe only 10 minutes. And for me and for people that really love journaling and get so much out of it, it can be even much longer. But it's not about the time. It's about the sincerity of putting down what you're dealing with, what you're feeling, what you're desiring, what you're wanting, what you're fearing. Putting your pen down and listening to the coach within you. Like I coach the people that I coach and train, both in life coaching as well as professional coaching. And they listen and they write that down. I told the woman yesterday that I was on the phone to, as I began to share with her, I said two things. Don't ever, ever have a conversation one-on-one with me and not have a pen and pencil in hand or iPad or whatever you use. And number two, when I coach you on video, I said I will record that and send it back to you so that you can have it to what? What? Review. The power of review. So until tomorrow, start journaling, start reviewing, and get that power going within you. And tomorrow, I really am looking forward to a really neat class-like sharing. And maybe, just maybe, it'll be even a deeper level of how to use journaling on a lifestyle development of building your life plan better and better. Because, you know, it's nothing worse than, you know, setting a plan or a map and not following it. I want you to follow the plan to your success, to your breakthrough, to your victory, to your healing, to your relationship, to your wedding, to your success in business, to whatever it is, to your weight loss, to your dietary exercise, all those things. But it takes a map, and journaling becomes the most powerful map you'll ever have in your life. Have a beautiful day of reviewing. Tonight, when you get back ready for bed, maybe review this video to remind you. There's another example of reviewing. And share this. And if you really want some more additional depth in regards to inspiration, two venues I've given you on this page. You can find the links right on this page right here. It says, go to my blog. And when you go to my blog, the Jeffrey Paul blog, you can go under the tab that says inspiration. And there's dozens, and I think there's hundreds of videos and teachings and inspirations and lessons there that you can watch. And if you go to my YouTube for the inspiration, which is a link right there as well, you can go on to all of these morning sessions for over a year or better. And you'll see the topics that maybe just even a year ago, review, a year ago inspired you, and today it could inspire you again because it becomes fresh and new all over again when you review. That's the power of review. So have a beautiful day. I look forward to seeing you in a little longer version tomorrow on Sunday morning at 7:30. And for all of you, continue to remember that you are beautiful inside and out. And Angela, you're being healed, and we just want to send the prayers and all our wishes for good health for you and all of you that are out there, Susan and Michelle, Janet, and Judith and each and every one of you. Thank you for being with me every morning. It's precious and wonderful to see your names pop up, your hearts and your thumbs come across to my screen, and to know that you're being inspired, because that's my goal in my life. Have a beautiful day. I'll see you tomorrow.